Embattled, FairPoint Communications filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy today. The company's CEO says this could reduce its debt by $1.7 billion and help secure the company's future. News 8's Cam Tran is live on what this could mean for FairPoint's 1.3 million customers. Cam?
Well, Tori, the company told us that customers shouldn't be seeing any interruptions in service. They also say they're still making an income. In fact, they plan on expanding their operations in the future.
This does not need to be a surprise.
A surprise that FairPoint Communications voluntarily filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy just 18 months after taking over landlines from Verizon Communications.
Because it's a Chapter 11, it's strictly a restructuring tool. It allows us literally and figuratively to reduce the debt on the books.
Reduce the debt from $2.7 billion down to $1 billion. FairPoint's President Peter Nixon says this effort to dig the company out of the red would not affect its current service, and the company will continue expanding its broadband internet across Maine.
We checked with the call center earlier today. We're taking today over 90% of our calls are being answered in less than 20 seconds. So we are at full service. Our installers are out.
And the state's Public Utility Commission says it will make sure FairPoint, despite its financial woes, will hold up its end of the bargain.
And we will hold FairPoint to those commitments, and that's part of what we will do in the bankruptcy proceeding is make sure that those interests are protected, that we can continue to enforce our orders and hold FairPoint to the commitments they've made.
Now, Governor Baldacci says he, along with officials from New Hampshire and Vermont, will keep a very close eye on these hearings. In fact, the Maine PUC has hired a bankruptcy lawyer to keep Mainers' interests at heart. Now, if you want to take a look at how they plan on restructuring their debt, log on to our website, WMTW.com. Live in Portland, Cam Tran, News 8.